back for our sixth installment of our at-home workouts. We got six. We've been away from the gym that long. We miss you guys. It is empty and lonely in the gym. We cannot wait for you guys to get back. But in the meantime, we're gonna keep working out at home. And today, we have a really good workout for us. There's gonna be a lot of running. So you're gonna need a couple of things. One is space. Claire loves having space around her. The second thing is, you're gonna need some weights, some lightweight dumbbells, or you can substitute with soup cans, bottles of water. You don't need them to be too terribly heavy. A 3-pound dumbbell is fine. Two bottles of water are fine. You're also gonna need some awareness of distance. I'm gonna ask us to do a 200 meter run. That's the length of two football fields. So you run the length of one football field, then run back, that's gonna be 200 meters. We're gonna do that a bunch of times today. Because we're preparing for Murph, and Murph has a pretty long run in it. So we need to build up our capacity to handle a good distance run. So we're gonna begin the way we always do with a warm up. We're gonna do a focus skill session, and then we'll have an actual workout. At the end of our session, we'll have a cool down. I have a terrific yoga session for us that we can really focus on finding ways of feeling victorious in times that are difficult. So let's demonstrate the warm up. It's gonna be fairly simple. I'm gonna do 10 one-legged hops, then 10 one-legged hops on the other leg, then 10 hollow rocks, then 10 Superman holds. Then we're gonna do some somersaults, cartwheels, log rolls, whatever you wanna do. Claire and I will demonstrate quickly what the movements are. So Claire, show them what a one-legged hop is. Hopping on one leg. Claire, show them what it looks like on the other leg. Perfect. That's gonna be the first part of the workout, of the warm-up. Now, for a hollow rock, we're gonna get onto the ground. Think about keeping our chest hollow, like there's nothing there. Lift our legs up, put our arms over our heads. We want to be mostly on our butt and on our lower back. Then we simply rock back and forth. That's one. Now, a Superman roll is something you guys love to do. We're gonna pretend we're Superman, arms out, legs up, and simply roll. And that is a Superman roll. So, let's turn the music up a little bit. Get a little loud. Let's do 10 one-legged hops. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, 10 hollow rocks. Up, legs up, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, Claire. So tough to get a balance on this. Try to stay balanced right in that lower back area. Now, Superman roll. Let's come this way first. Go ahead. Nice. I'm going to go right behind her. Arms up, feet up, good. Arms out, arms up, good. Arms out, feet out. Perfect. Now, 5 cartwheels, somersaults, or log rolls. I'm just doing a log roll. Watch this. Arms in. Alright guys, that's your warm up. Grab some water, hydrate those bodies. Alright, grab some water. I'm having my Fit Aid. Better just hydrate a little bit. Believe it or not, you should be winded. So, our focus skill for today is gonna be air squats. We're gonna be building up our capacity and our technique for air squats leading into the upcoming Murph. We're gonna do a 2x10 of a slow air squat. Then we're gonna do a 2x10 of a fast air squat. So why don't you guys find a little position for yourself in your house? Here. For our slow squats, we're gonna go at a 3-second tempo. We've done this before. So get your feet about a little wider than shoulder width apart. Connect your thumbs down below. Bring them up like a butterfly or Iron Man. Hinge at the hips. Now go down for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Stay on those heels. 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna be pushing up from those heels. A little slower, Claire. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. We have one more. 1, 2, 3. There you go. All right, shake those legs out. We're gonna give ourselves about a 30-second break, letting our legs recover a little bit. Remember, keep that weight in your heels. If you're coming forward on your toes, just wiggle those little toes a little bit. That'll get you back onto your heels. Ready? All right, feet. A little wider than shoulder width. Connect your thumbs, bring them up like a butterfly or Iron Man. Hinge the hips. Then go down slowly. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. A little slower. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. How many more we got?
2 more.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There you go. That's a good slow paced squat. We'll be focused on staying in those heels and pushing up from those heels. Now, we're gonna do a 2x10 of a fast squat. When we're doing Murph, we wanna be moving through our movements at a quick pace. So we're gonna show you a technique to use, a way of holding your hands to let your body build up momentum going both down and up. So, same positioning. Feet a little wider than shoulder width. You want to start with your hands by your side. As you go down, you bring them up to your chest and then pop right up. You don't gotta swing them that far. I was being a little bit over dramatic with this. A little too fast of a swing, but that's gonna be the movement pretty much. So let's do 10 of those. Try to do it fast, but controlled. You guys ready? Hands by your side, bring them up to your chest, then pop up. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you notice, once I got going on my third or fourth, I even stopped bringing them up to my chest and just slowed them out in front of my arm or in front of my knees. So however you can do them fast, but staying in good form, staying on your heels, and moving through that movement is gonna be the best. So, you good? Back and win. Okay, let's set our feet up again. Make sure they're a little wider than shoulder width. Start with your hands by your sides, then go. We're not trying to go too fast. We wanna go fast enough so we're still in control. You ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How's that feel? 8, 9, 10. Claire's in her heels really nicely. No going forward at all. She did really, really well. If you feel like there's a little bit of air between your heels and the ground, wiggle those toes. All right, that's it for our skill workout today. Grab some water, hydrate. You might be winded again. We just did 40 squats. That's a lot of squats. So get yourself some water. We have our WOD coming up. Our WOD is going to be a 200 meter run, then 20 squats. We're doing them with a pace. You're trying to do them fast. So 20 air squats, then a 200 meter run, followed by 15 push-ups, then a 200 meter run, followed by 10 pull-ups. Most of you probably do not have a pull-up bar, so we're gonna do bent over rows, which we learned last week, and you're gonna finish with a 200 meter run. Claire and I will show you some of the scaling for the push-ups in the row. Stand up. Can you get your dumbbells down? Right over in this area. So for push-ups, the standard push-up is being into a plank position, going down, touching your chest to the ground, and going straight up, locking those arms out. There are a couple of acceptable movements to scale it. One is to inchworm. You can inchworm your body, pushing your chest up and bringing your legs up. The other scaling is going onto your knees. Same thing, chest to the ground, lock the hands out. Now, that's for the push-up. Claire's gonna show us the bent over row. So face sideways, dumbbells. Kneel down, pick them up. Pick them up to your waist. Just bend down, keeping her back straight. Back straight, good. Row, all the way up. That's good. So now, try not to round that back. Bring it down, keep that back nice and straight. One, two, three. So why don't you guys take a second, set your area up, and try to figure out where 200 meters is. We know in our gym, it's the second mailbox. Football field, and then back. This wad is gonna be a total of a half mile of running. So it's a good amount of running for us. So Claire's gonna open the door. We're gonna turn the music up. We're gonna get some party rock music going on. You're gonna take us outside. Ready, kiddo? All right, this will probably be about a 7 or 8 minute workout. So you guys ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Claire's coming out hot again. Man, she comes out hot with this run. She makes me work for it. It is not fun sometimes for me to work out with old Claire Bear. I feel my legs getting sore. I already feel it. All right, coming up to our second mailbox. Pretty awesome. Then we come back in. We're gonna knock out 20 squats. But remember, trying to do them fast. Trying to burn through them pretty quickly. You guys are being troopers by watching us take you guys out for a run like this. You guys should not even be watching this right now. You should be out for a run. So you're probably not even that impressed with us. So Claire's gonna begin her squats right now. Unbroken. It's fine to break them up if you need to. Your legs should be pretty sore right now. Use this run to recover. If you need to start slow, let those legs recover a bit. Start slow. You'll probably pick up the pace towards the end. We're gonna do another 200 meters and then back in.
to knock out 15 air squats. I'm sorry, 15 push-ups. Claire just glared at me as I said that. Good work, honey. Good job, everybody. You guys should actually not be watching this if you're doing the workout, but keep it up. You're very, very good. Now set up, find an area, 15 push-ups. Scale them however you need to. There's Hop, take off her sweatshirt. More meters. I told you, a lot of running today. Nice. Claire's already moving. See if I can catch her. Bet you I can. She's moving pretty good. She's gonna. Claire does a great job at avoiding bugs. That's her skill set. If there's a bug, she'll avoid it. Good job, hon. Keep up the good work. Nice. Do a little turnaround. We'll go in. We'll finish up with 10 bent over rows. Should be a quick movement, and then finish up with 200 meters. Good run, Claire. I didn't even catch you. Back straight. Back straight. Straighter. Set up for our yoga cool down. Music goes down. I'm gonna move us over to our yoga area. Pick up the camera, take it with me. Here we go. Whew, that was a good run. Good run. Claire's moving pretty quickly right now. This cool down should be about 4 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes. So set up an area for yourself that is comfortable in front of the TV. If you wanna actually pause, you can press the pause button and go to the actual video itself on your TV. Or you can just watch Claire and I do it. We're gonna do it right here along with you. Claire, good job. Good job. Grab some water, hydrate. What was that? That's good. That was good. You got a good half mile. Good work today. Any water? Water? There. All right, good job today, guys. Good work. You should be talking. You might feel like this right now. Claire is exhausted. Hydrate those bodies. I use my fitting for recovery. Claire's got some good H2O, good water. Oxygen is very, very important right now to be getting into your body. So, Claire's gonna set up here.
Can I sleep?
Claire asked if she could sleep. I said, no, not yet. Yes, she can, but not right now. So, we're gonna get our go noodle wind down set up. So, Claire's gonna stand up with me.
When nervousness takes over, it can be hard to be our best self, but our bodies are here to help. This exercise will show you how to grow.
Your body's ready. Face the screen, stand up.
Close your eyes
and follow along.
Do what works best for you. Stand up. Reach your arms out in front of you. Tilt your fingertips up. Your palms are facing the screen. Pause there for a moment. Now slowly let your arms swing down to your sides and then back behind you. Press your hands. Tilt your fingertips down. Your palms are facing the back of the room. Remain like that for just a little bit. When you're ready, let your arms and your hands come forward again. Palms facing the screen. Breathe in. Breathe out as your arms slowly swing down and then back up behind you again. Fingertips pointing down. Breathe normally now. Allow your arms to return to your sides. Next, make fists and bring them to rest on the sides of your waist. Your elbows might feel like they're sticking out. They're supposed to. Try standing a bit taller. Raise your chin just a little. Close your eyes or keep them open. Notice that you are breathing as you stand strong. Pay attention to your breath while the rest of you remains still but energized. Try to stay for the count of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now let your arms reach up and wide, like you're forming the letter V with your arms. Spread your fingers as wide as you can. V stands for victory. The cool thing is that your body and brain already know that. So when you get in this position, it might feel like something is going really well for you. Victory. By the way, yawning is okay.
Oh my God, thank you.
Stay a little longer, if it's okay for your body. Reach and breathe. You are building strength of attitude with every breath, with every second. Let's stay here a moment more. Feel the victory from inside. Feel your awesome self. When you're ready, let your arms slowly float down to your sides. Breathe in and out, slowly. Quietly notice how you feel at this moment. Just notice for you. Rest a bit, just standing still.
Really good job today. I hope you feel victorious. I'm gonna give Claire a roller right now so she can roll out her back after that running and squats. She probably has a little bit of a tightness in her back. You guys can roll out. Thank you guys for coming today.